So one day I'm getting my philosophy on, trying to understand some deep thoughts about justice and the universe, when I turn the page and the book stops speaking English. Out of nowhere, it was all weird mathy symbols. Backwards E, A to the X, to the scary arrows, therefore justice! So I did what any reasonable human would do. I panicked, I closed the book, I hid the evidence. When language starts looking like math, I am out of there so fast. This, and I run fast, because I train every day. Now I'm a coder, and that terrifying moment was way more relevant to my career than I could ever have imagined. Freaking logic. Welcome to Comp Chomp, the only show on the internets where, for all X, where X is a world, I say hello to X. Now that surprise logic hiding in my philosophy book wasn't frustrating because I'm afraid of math and science and logic. I'm a girl. I hate math. No, it was because I did not expect it to be there. I lived in a world where you have language and history and big ideas on one side, and on the other side, across a huge chasm, I think I used to say chasm, don't laugh at me, was numbers and data. And the two did not mix. But then the walls, they came down. If I weren't blinded by that trauma, I could have appreciated my first taste of what's known as a formal language. It's when math and language have a hideous love child. It's probably not the exact definition, but it is pretty darn close. I do not want to get all into formal languages, because that book still haunts me. But I will say one thing about this man. Look at that hair! Leibniz, mathematician, polymath, and wig wearer extraordinaire. Extraordinaire? It rhymes, so it works. He got appointed as courtier to the royal duchy of the House of Brunswick. I think I got that right. I am not European, but I do feel quite regal. Though his fancy employers grumbled because he didn't spend a lot of time focusing on his work, he spent his time coming up with logic. I bet that makes you feel kind of bad about your side projects. This dude invented logic. I made a one-page app that tweets when my favorite celebrity tweets. Anyway, he discovered that all of our ideas were made up of small, tiny pieces that you can build up into complex statements. That's kind of almost computery. So close. Just missing the machine, big wig. Thanks to his logic, we can connect any two ideas with an operator to make one of his complex statements. I mean, we can say cookies and ice cream, or dogs and cats, or X and Y, and that and always works the same way. If we have both of them, the statement is true, and if we don't, it's false. I mean, if I turn up and you promise puppies and kittens and there were only puppies, you've got some splaining to do. Easily, you should have said or, which is another operator, like connecting X or Y. Only one has to be there for it to be true. But getting all logic-y on you here? What if both of them are there? What if there are puppies and kittens and you told me there would be puppies or kittens? Well, it's still true. That is how or works. It is only false when both of them aren't there. And do you know what works exactly like that? Seriously, these are all the same in code. Yeah. Just like logic, programming languages are formal languages. As we saw in my collaboration over on NativLang, natural languages aren't the only way to be a language. And if I had kept that book open, I would have learned that lesson a bit sooner. I will see you next week, and remember, comment or subscribe. Chomp!